Let's all stand as we begin our service of thanksgiving the life of our sister and friend Hannibal. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Cast your burden on the Lord, and he will sustain you. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. None of us lives to himself, and none of us dies to himself. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We lift our voices in song. We turn to the worship bulletin that we have, the comforting hymn, Amazing Grace. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas great that tore my heart to fear, and grace my fears.
When this flesh and heart
feel. And mortal life shall cease. I shall possess within the field a life of joy and peace. The earth shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbear to shine, but God will call me here below, will be forever mine. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. Amen.
Please be seated. We unite our hearts in prayer. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-loving Father, you are the source of all that is good. You created us in your image and likeness. You blessed us and placed us on this earth. You called us to follow you. And you called and you formed your daughter, Hanifa. Today we gather as family and friends to say goodbye. But we know, Lord, as we stand in the presence of death, we also stand in the presence of life. We believe the words called Hanifa lived the faith. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. So today, as we say goodbye to the body, as the memories continue to flood our minds, may we grieve, but not as people who have no hope, but let us grieve with the knowledge of one day we shall all meet again. So guide us now, O Lord, that all that is said and done will be to the upliftment of the spirit of the members of this family. In your holy and blessed name we pray. Amen. Our interim minister will now read for us a Bible passage taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 8 to 18.
Our scripture lesson this morning comes from 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 8 to 18. We listen to the word of God. We are afflicted in every way, but not crushed. Perplexed, but not driven to despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Always carrying in the body the death of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be manifested in our bodies. For while we live, we are always being given up to death for Jesus' sake, so that the life of Jesus may be manifested in our mortal flesh. So death is at work in us, but life in you. Since we have the same spirit of faith as he had wrote, I believe and so I spoke, we to believe and so we speak, knowing that he who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and bring us with you into his presence. For it is all for your sake, so that as grace extends to more and more people, it may increase thanksgiving to the glory of God. So we do not lose heart, though our outer nature is wasting away, our inner nature is being renewed every day. For this slight momentary affliction is preparing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison. Because we look not to the things that are seen, but to the things that are unseen. For the things that are seen are transient, but the things that are unseen are eternal. This is the word of God.
It's a new normal. If it was an ordinary day, we would not be able to count the amount of people who would have been here to say goodbye to Hanifa. I think she knew everybody from Riaparo to Mayaro and maybe Grandy as well. But it's a different time and we have certain restrictions we have to follow. But I'm sure all of us present have a memory, something special about Hannifer. So at this time, we'll have Ellen and Terry sharing their memories with us.
Children. She attended Mayara Government School in her primary years and then went to Guyadine's private secondary school in Rio Claro. You know, the funny thing is when I was writing this, she would be the one I would ask all this information about. She would be the one who would know everything. So this was a bit hard for me. This is where she met the love of her life, Jagdeo Ramdevan, in 1962, and later became Hannifer Ramdevan Khan. Mommy was a very devoted wife and mother. She spent her time taking care of her younger siblings and her children. To occupy her time, she held various positions such as secretary of Mafeking's Women's Group and member of the village council. She took part in various classes in the community center as well. Later on, Mommy became a postal officer and continued until retirement. Mommy worked in almost every post office in this country. She would get up extremely early, prepare breakfast and lunch for us all, and then take the bus and go to offices in places like Tacarigua, Arauca, Sangre Grande, and even Port of Spain. Bet your bottom dollar. She's coming back home and making dinner and starting the cycle all over again the next day. I don't know how she did it. Working in the post office was a good and a bad. You could get your mail posted easily, but Lord, she knew everyone, and everyone knew her. And if they knew her, they knew us. So we had a lot of spies. She knew every move that we made, even before we made it. She was quite a hostess as well. That little house on the junction that we grew up in was always filled with people. From all our friends sleeping over to family spending the weekends and holidays. We never really knew how everyone would fit. But somehow Mommy would find a way, pulling out pillows and sheets from hiding places we didn't even know of, and made everyone comfortable. Let's not talk about the food. She would prepare so many meals that you just get confused what to put together in your plate. Always feeding us every minute. I'm just so surprised I'm not fat. Mommy was one of the kindest persons I ever knew. I would look at how she would jump to help anyone that needed help. Everyone she came across in her life, she had assisted in one way or another. If you needed information about anything, she was the one who could help. If you needed to know how the government services operated, ask Hannifer. If you're in a financial strain, she was willing to help. She knew how to get things done. Who else you know got their phone stolen and went and get it back from the person who stole it? Hannifer. She wasn't someone who could hold a grudge for too long. She would come back and talk like if nothing happened, which was her way of apologizing. She taught us that when big people have disagreements, that has nothing to do with us. Mommy loved to travel as well. She knew how to have fun. She couldn't stay put for a long time before she decided to call her travel agent and book a ticket to wherever she wanted. Everywhere she traveled, she made friends easily, especially Margarita. She knew no Spanish, but every day calling the tour guide and others from Margarita. Mommy was very involved in the church for a number of years. She held the position of secretary and was also a trustee in the Mafeking Presbyterian Church, a place we all spent a lot of our years. Mom, we would miss you so much. You've touched so many lives. We used to get mad sometimes when you're always on the phone. But someone said to me recently, you didn't find the time to talk. You made the time, and that is rare. We would miss how you would make all sorts of food for us to take home. Pack us up with large bags of goodies. I remember once when I was working and my mother packed up a huge bag. I had just had Adrian. A huge bag of food for every day of the week for me. Every day. Because she knew all the stress that I was going through. A meal for every single day. I traveled in that bus and brought it to work for me. How would you make some inappropriate jokes to Daddy? And we all had to exclaim, oh Lord, Mommy, not now. Those early Saturday phone calls, when we're happy we can get an extra hour of sleep, she would call and ask, Mayaro, here I come, trying to see if we would make the drive down. Let's not forget her nieces, her nephews, her grandkids. Lord, how she loved them so much. There was nothing she wouldn't do for them. For some, she even took the title of mother. The night before Mom passed away, she called me. But this conversation was so different from all the others. I had so many questions I wanted answered. I was feeling so lost and confused at the time. One after another, I was shooting questions and patiently she was answering as best as she could. That night she shared so many things. She shared her life growing up, the family, the emotional pain she was feeling about certain things. She shared and I listened and I thank God that I got to share that with her. You, Mom, were one of the strongest persons I ever knew. You went through so much physical challenges and always seemed to be the odds. Stroke, heart attack, everything you could think about. I secretly hoped that this time was no different, but it wasn't. As the saying goes, in life, we loved you dearly. In death, we love you still. In our hearts, you hold a place no one will ever fill. You were an icon. A pillar in the community, a devoted wife, a caring mother, aunt, grandmother, a friend to so many, near and far, a confidant, the glue that held us all together. Don't know how to move on from here, because you left some big shoes to fill. We love you, Mom, now and always.
My sister said it all, but the New Testament, Mark 8:36 says, "For what is the profit of man? Well, for what is the profit of man who gained the world but loses his soul?" My mom, for the last 20 years, she's been saying that to me every time I call her. I never could understand what it means until now. She's always telling me, "You know, you'll figure it out," and I actually figured out what does it mean. She means that life is short and we gotta live it to the fullest. And that's what I actually figured out after all these years. After calling, I call my mom every single day and she says that to me at least twice a week. She was someone that asked you, did you eat? You took your medications? Did you stop working so hard? Stop doing this. For me, she's my hero. Only a hero does that to us. Only a hero gets up and cooks you a meal in the morning before you go to school when we're kids. Only a hero makes sure you have money in your pockets. And our everyday life, our moms are heroes. And if we don't see that as kids, they are a hero every day I get up. I get them that phone call from her every single day when if I don't call her, she calls me to remind me that, you know, stop working. But now I actually figure out what she means. My mom is a hero in so many ways that I can't even imagine it and can't even explain it to her grandkids, to everybody, to her husband. She gets up every day and she cooked for my dad, and you know, she was the life of this house. Meaning that when you come here, it's either the phone ringing, the other phone ringing, the TST ringing, the B-Mobile ringing, the pots pinging up in the back in the kitchen there, Jack is smoking the cigarette in the back there, and it's just like, you know, okay, I'm coming, but that's with the life of this house. Now, when you hear it, it's just dead. My mom was the life of this house. My mom was the life. And could it ever be filled by us? I don't know, but I will try to follow her footsteps and do it the best we can. Mom, I love you from the bottom of my heart, and you leave a big gap to fill. I don't know if I can fulfill it, but I promise you, I will try my best to do it for you. From your kids, we will try. We will try, we will try, we will try.
As we sing the hymn, "What a Friend We Have in Jesus, All Our Sins and Griefs to Be In."
What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. Oh, because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. And we find a friend so faithful, who will all our sorrows share. Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. But with the Lord of care, precious Savior, still our refuge, take it to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friends despise, forsake thee, take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms you take and shield thee. Thou wilt find a solace still. Amen.
Let us pray. Allow us, O Lord, to be comforted by your Holy Spirit. Guide our thoughts so we not think about loss, but the memories will comfort us of love, joy, and peace. May what we say at this time comfort us, so that the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable to you, our Savior and our Redeemer. Amen. A woman who had an opinion about everything and was not afraid to let you know what she thought about you, what you were doing, and what you should be doing. Hannifer was a person who could be larger than life, or she could simply fade away and you never knew that she was there. If she liked you, then she was in your face, because you were her own. If she didn't care for you, well, she'll be in and out. Through the church, got to know her. Through her work, everybody knew her. And by the sheer friends and friendships she had, she included everybody. Whether you were family of birth, marriage, faith, community, she considered you family. Today we gather to mourn a woman who truly knew what it was to love. A woman who didn't have an easy life, but made the best out of everything. Hospitality, generosity, kindness. If we don't know how to explain, to articulate what those words mean, when we think about Hanifa, we know what we felt. Today we gather, and there are so many who would have wished to be here because she touched their life in some way or the other. But today for her family, we are here to remember and to give God thanks for her, for she truly made a difference in the lives of those who knew her, whom she knew, and whom she loved. Today, as we gather together, we need to remember that this is not the end. Too often, when we think about death, we think that this is the end, because the last memory we will have is of this casket and what is in it being staying one place and we going somewhere else. But that is not the end. And this is a woman who loved the Lord. Heaven and earth may pass away, but my word continues. She knew, because she comforted others, that we are here for a short time. The psalmist says, our time upon this earth is like the grass, like the flowers, a very short time. But in the time that we are here, what do we do? She was a person who lived life to the fullest. When, as her daughter said, when she could travel, Margarita was her home. She would not go by herself, though. She made sure people who never traveled, who never had a passport, got one, because she would round up her friends, they would go. By the time they come home from one trip, she'd gone somewhere else. She had different friends, you know. She had the Margarita friends. She had those who they would go liming in Trinidad with, others who went further abroad. So she wasn't with the same group all the time. She went all over. Today we have this confidence that this woman of faith, a woman who served the Lord, she may not have preached a sermon from the pulpit, but her life reflected what she believed.
Get vaccinated as soon as possible. Go to your appointment today.
Today we know that death is not the end, because we live, what Jesus said. I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. So we know that the body is no more, but Hanifa is still there. A large and a life person who has done so much, and that memory of serving, that memory of kindness, will motivate any and all of us to continue to do our best to make sure that she'll always be proud of who we are, wherever we are, and what we are doing. While she was here, she faced many, many challenges, health issues. And everything you saw, every time you saw that Hanifa is down, she will rise up, surprising everyone. But today she's going to rise in a different way. In the Christian church, last Sunday was Pentecost Sunday. The gift of the Comforter came to help the Christians to go forward. Today, she will not have to wait for anyone to motivate. She will be safe in the arms of Jesus. The body will be no more. Dust, earth, elements. But she will live, because she will reign in all our hearts. So how do we continue? How do we persevere? How do we face tomorrow? From the time we heard the news of what had happened, there was something to do, even if it was simply waiting. You knew you couldn't go forward, you had to wait. But now what will we do after today? What will we be waiting for? What call is going to come? Who is going to remind us what to do? How are we going to continue to live? Because even though sometimes the phone calls might have been in that time inconvenient, now we would long for that phone call. Long for that voice to tell us what to do, ask us what we are doing. But we do not lose hope. Death cannot defeat us. Yes, we will be lonely. We'll be afraid. We'll hold our loved ones that much closer to us. But you don't lose hope, because there's a beautiful picture that is painted for us with words that comes from the book of Revelation. The writer says, I looked and I saw people from every tribe and every generation standing before the throne, standing before the Lamb of God, and with one voice praising God. There were days when Hanifa couldn't reach the church, and you'd miss her. Between Hanifa and Beulah, you know, those voices, they couldn't miss in church when they were singing. Sometimes you'd ask, so why weren't you in church last week? Oh, Jack, they got all the blame. He didn't come home in time. He didn't buy chicken. He's sleeping. So she needed transport to reach her church. She was a woman who had hope that where she was, what she had, would always have something better. But she didn't wait for the better. She enjoyed what she had. You know, sometimes we always want something perfect and we're looking forward to something that we don't appreciate and value what is right before us. Not Hanifa. She appreciated and valued what she had and enjoyed what she had. But she also looked to the future, knowing that no matter what she had, there will be something coming even greater, better, and she would be prepared to utilize all that she had. So for us, her Jagdeh, her children, grandchildren, a community, body of faith, how do we continue? The writer says, I looked and saw this great multitude, and there was no more pain. There was no hunger, thirst. There was calm, there was good. They worshipped God. And that, my dear brothers and sisters, is the promise that this fulfilled. That as much as she had overcome these past years, the body was still frail. It wasn't as strong as it once was. She did so much, but as Paul said, she completed the race. She crossed the finish line. And while she looks for this crown of glory, what are we doing? What have we done with the life given to us? As we were reminded, Hanifa had to struggle for what she wants. She had to work for what she wants. She had work, she had family, she had church, she had community. And she made time for everyone. Maybe some felt shortchanged, but she did what she had to do. What are we doing with the life that we have, the days that we have? Because one day, this will be us. Will we have regrets? The one thing I know, how to live for life without regrets. There were certain things obviously we want to do, we can't do everything. But for the most part, she never lived looking back. And she planned well. She kind of knew what she wanted things to be and what to do, and she planned accordingly. So today, we do not have regrets. Do not have regrets for what Hanifa, in your and my opinion, did or didn't do. She was a woman who did great things. But we need to look at our lives. What are we doing? What have we left undone? What we are promising for tomorrow? Tomorrow may not come. For today, there is a sometimes say, safe in the arms of Jesus, safe in his embrace, there by his love or shade, sweetly my soul shall rest. That is our prayer for Hannah for today, to be safe in the arms of Jesus. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Unite your hearts in prayer, let us pray. Almighty and ever-loving Father, what a pleasure, privilege, and honor it was to have known your daughter, Hannifer, for these many years. We thank you, Lord, for her life. We thank you for the friends and friendships she made. We thank you for her hospitality in opening her home to all those who came, who shared a meal, who shared laughter, who introduced others to the church, and who literally helped to build the physical church. We thank you, Lord, for our sister and friend Hannifer, and we pray that as you welcome her home, as the body will be no more, that you in your mercy and love will forgive her if she has made any mistakes along the way. Lord, we acknowledge Jackie, her husband for these many years. Through her marriage vows, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, sickness and health, they stayed together. They built tangible and intangible dreams, hopes and aspirations, homes, family. Lord, we pray that you will be with them, that you will be able to continue to face tomorrow. Thank you today, Justin, Ronald, Perry, Ellen. We know, Lord, that as siblings, friends, they will support and encourage one another in all endeavors. Each will face their life, but we know that siblings know themselves and each other better than everyone else. Pray, O Lord, that you will be there for them and with them. As siblings, may they always support and encourage each other in all endeavors. We thank you and we pray for the grandchildren. Lord, we know that a grandparent brings so much joy, unexpected blessing. And we pray that parents will share the memory of their grandparent. For those who join this family, for all those who knew and loved our sister and friend, pray, O Lord, that you will give them the strength, the grace, and the love to continue. For all those who are left behind, fill our hearts with love, that we may hold on to that old rugged cross, that cross that reminds us that there is life, there is joy in death. Show us the way, O Lord, that we may go in this darkened path that we travel when we are uncertain of tomorrow. May we continue trusting you, O Lord, and you will provide for us. Gracious and ever-loving Father, support us all the day long of this troublesome life until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed and the fever of life is over. Then, of your tender mercy, grant us a safe lodging and welcome us in your holy presence. We ask in and through the blessed name of Jesus Christ. You taught us when we pray to say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be here. Let's all stand as we sing this our closing hymn.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the silver birds shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and all work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
Amen.
Let us pray. The peace of God which passeth all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest, remain, and abide with us this day and forevermore.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. We'll give you all a little time to do the body once more before we conclude the service at the burial ground. today is just a little hard to do at the graveside of the metal. So we both of us prefer to do it there than to do it here. So we'll be going. So take this moment and say goodbye, because it will be different by the cemetery.
We're not opening up the casket.
Well, it depends. If you want to find a look there, you can do it.
Yeah,
you're wondering already.